when we came in, we came into your office right here and all the busyness that was going on and the things that was going through my mind, I need you to just answer for me. What was it like coming out from Marcy Projects in Brooklyn? That's right.
Yeah.
What is it like, you know, what was the journey like? Give me an idea from the projects to CEO.
Right there, you know, that's a lot of, you know, that's a struggle within itself. There's a lot of obstacles in your way, a lot of things sidetrack you from things that you want to do. You know what I mean? And then you don't really know what you want to do because, you know, the people around you that's most attainable to you, accessible, that's right there. But, you know, hustling or what have you, you know, doing other activities. So that's the most accessible thing. First, you have to get over that. You have to look past that. You know, and I went through that.
Let me ask you something else. What percentage do you think a hip-hop artist will have, like, a secure future? See, because obviously you have a business mind. Mm-hmm. A mind, not just only a talent to fire off the lyric, but you have a talent for business also. What percentage of artists do you think I have a financially secure future maybe 10 years from now out of 100%?
Hopefully with these companies coming out, we want to start looking, start, you know, realizing that they have a lot more power than they think. Because rappers' life is like about 3 albums. The average rapper, unless you are old somebody, you know, they're going to endure during the times. You know, that's a special case. You know, those are special cases, but, you know, it's like 3%. I believe either 3 to 5% of artists have a successful career. It's crazy, right? That's a bad 3 to 5%.
Yeah,
and they domestic that go platinum. You know what I mean? So I mean, rappers, they have a lot of power. I just want to know, you know, I just want, you know, I mean, we following all the companies that's before us, you know, Death Row, Bad Boy, you know, Wu-Tang did their thing as far as establishing their whole clique, you know what I mean? Mm. Hopefully, you know, this is a trend, you know, and everyone else start getting companies because, you know, it's just so long before you get your money and get into, you know, to set yourself up. Which does it for the rappers. You know, royalties come every 6 months. You know, by this time they had spent about $1 million on you or what have you. So then you have to recoup that first. So then that 6 months is pushed back to when you recoup that, which is another month, which is a year. You know what I mean? It's just so many, you know, now you are platinum artist or what have you. And you're looked at in a certain way, so you have to live a certain lifestyle. Okay, they're gonna front you the money, you get your house and everything, and you get your little vehicle, which meets, you know, how the public perceive you.
Right.
Okay, now the little money that you get from tour, you got to spend that on, you know, maintaining a house and maintaining a car and everything. You know, that's what happens to a lot of rappers. You know, their money situation, that's exactly that.
That's a lot, you know.
You know, they probably never understood that until just now, like, that is what happened.
That's like, and as I'm listening to you, that parallels the game a whole lot. Like, yeah, man, I'm gonna hit you with this, but when the time comes time to get your money, I got to take that back out, you know, and
that's
if
right.
You're not mindful of the mathematics,
that's right,
the economics, then they might wind up taking out, recouping a little bit more than they put out.
And then I ain't even mentioned that. You know what I mean? And that was just, yeah, and that was them being fair.
Right.
You know what I mean? Imagine
if, fair.
Yeah, and you know, we all have seen, and you know, we've heard, and you know, some of us witnessed that, you know, it ain't all fair. Record business is shady at times.
Do you think that hip-hop can do as well as it's doing without the hustle connection, without the murder connection, the drug and violence connection? Could hip-hop do as well as it's doing now without that image?
Well, hip-hop, you know, I think it's like crying. It's like a scream from the ghetto. Like, you know what I mean? Like, yo, this is what's going on in here. You know what I mean? I wouldn't want to see it. I wouldn't want to see it without that, stripped of that. You understand? I will always want to see that street aspect and the young kids crying and screaming, you know, what's going on.
Oh, okay.
I mean, because then everyone forgets. I mean, they know, but they trying to act like, you know, they know, but they like, that's not happening, that's not happening. Mm-hmm. But then you got all these records, he's selling 4 million records and 5 million records, and they like on his record, like, yo, I, you know, telling you what's going on, you can't ignore it, because then there's a big, you got to, you know, it's a bigger crowd that you got to ignore, that you got to close the door on.
Yeah, you, I mean, as many times as
that's like, Paul, I don't want to cut you off, and that's like me running to him, to the front door to the police, like, you know, I mean, yo, man, I'm just saying, they shooting out there or whatever, but they, and they know, but they don't want to address it. When I come back with my 4 million listeners, you know, it'd be much harder for them to close the door like that. You understand?